Hey guys, welcome back. Today we're going to be doing MC4 connectors. This is a 20-foot extension cable from BougeRV. You can get these in pretty much any length you can imagine, but these come with one end not crimped, so you can cut the cable to length and get the exact length of cable you need. These are PVC coated with UV protection, so you could put these in direct sunlight, although it's always best to have it in some sort of conduit. But let's get started. All right, so what do you get with the package? You get your extension cable, and you get a pair of MC4 connectors. So first thing we'll do is cut these. And this is the 10 gauge wire.
You do not need to take apart the connector in order to crimp it. Here I have it taken apart so that you can see what makes up a connector. Here we have the female connector, the male ferrule, compression sleeve, strain relief, and end cap. Let's see how the parts of the connector fit together while on the wire. When the end cap is threaded onto the connector, it will form a watertight seal via the compression sleeve. It will also compress the strain relief against the wire to create a tight fit. So this one is your male or positive connector, and this one is your female or negative connector.
Now, one thing that can be very confusing about these MC4 connectors is when you look at the ferrules, these are the little pins that go inside of the connectors. The female connector will actually go inside the male or positive end. And the male connector will go inside the female or negative end. It's a little bit confusing. And that's because these have to fit together, right? Like that. And also, these have to fit together. So that's why it's sort of backwards like that. This particular one is branded with Growatt, although the same kit is pretty much branded everywhere. It's the same kit when you buy these things. And I think they're about 20 or 30 bucks. I'll put the links in the description below. So the main tools you'll be interested in your kit are these, the crimpers, and then the two tightening wrenches. So these particular crimpers will do anywhere from a 2.5 up to a 6 millimeter wire. So I believe this is 10, 12, and 14 gauge. So we'll be using the 10. One nice thing about these crimpers are they're ratcheting. These are ratcheting crimpers. So you don't have to worry about, as you're crimping, it's gonna ratchet. So if you accidentally let go, it's not gonna release. You can reposition, or what are we going to do to get a better grip, and then keep on crimping down all the way. It only releases until the crimp has been completed. These are your tightening wrenches. So if you look at your connector, this hole will go like that around the actual connector. And then the other side goes on the threaded end, and you just operate it like that to tighten them. All right, so first we're gonna do the black wire. When you strip the wire back, these are already pre-stripped, so you don't have to worry about, if you buy these, you don't have to worry about stripping them, but when you do strip it, you want it to be about that much. Looks like about 1/4 inch. Just enough to get past these little wings here and just barely sit inside the ferrule like that. Okay, so when you're crimping, it's best to set the ferrule inside the crimpers first, because otherwise you're trying to balance the ferrule on the end of the wire, and it's a little bit difficult. So if you just do this first, don't press too much down on this, because you'll end up bending these and you won't be able to get the wire in. You may try to do it this way. This is wrong. You have to go this way, because it's going to basically fold. That's going to fold these over on each other. So we'll just hold it in place just like that. Insert our wire. Okay, wire is inserted. And just crimp down nice and firmly. Now, if you have a good crimp, you'll notice these wings are folded over perfectly. And you have a little bit of strands poking up through the top of the wings. This could have gone a little bit forward, I should have pushed in a little bit further so that the insulation is pushing against the connector, but it's okay. Next, we're going to take our female connector and we're just going to push our pin right through there until it snaps in place. If you have a good connection, if it's snapped in place, you will not be able to pull this off. Next, we can hand tighten the end. Once it gets pretty tight as you can go, use our wrench. Make sure you slide this one up as far as you can. And then tighten. When it starts snapping like that, that means you've reached the specified torque. And you don't need to go any further. That's it. The female connection is done. Next, we'll do our male connector with our female ferrule. Take the ferrule, put it inside the 10 gauge slot for your crimpers. Hold it loosely. Take your cable, insert it, and crimp down. That's perfect because the insulation is all the way against the ferrule and the tabs are folded over perfectly. Attach our connector. Clicked in. And tighten until it snaps. Now our cable is done. So one way to verify that you did it correctly, so each set of cables, black and red, will have two ends, obviously. And what you can do, we have the two ends of the negative wire, so you will have a female connection and a male connection, and you should be able to connect them together, just like that. Same with the red wire. Female and male, connect them together. And that's how you know you made your cable correctly. All right, now we have a perfectly good 20-foot extension cable ready to go. This has been a short video, so I'm glad to do a short video every once in a while. Usually my videos are quite long. But yeah, that's it. Thanks for watching.